Good day. Welcome to Tales from the Arctic, Episode 1. Oh, now that I hear it, that is a terrible title. Anyway, I lived in the Arctic for 2.5 years with my wife while she was up there nursing. For a few months I worked for Frobisher Inn. I found it way too boring because 90% of the time you stand around and do absolutely nothing, and for someone with my disability that is very stressful and it does not work. Anyway, one day I almost drove this particular truck off a cliff. Here it is. What happened is what you see here is as you drive over snow, it gets packed, turned into ice, they throw down sand, you drive over that, it gets packed into the ice, more snow falls, rinse repeats. So what you have is very sandy ice, and for a vehicle like this, it doesn't work so well. This is how we got it out. It's a wonderful machine. These guys are very skilled. They use this for moving sea crates as well as for plowing. They will have an attachment for the front, and he'll drive, get some speed up, and then extend the boom out and just slam it into piles of snow. I wish I would have filmed it. It's kind of amazing to watch how skilled these guys are. Here is the rut from me before I got all the way down. That's a good 4 inches of ice that I burned through trying to get out. Up here, it's more like 3. And up here, maybe 2. Here's the proof that I actually worked for Frobisher Inn, and there's a couple actors that I got to meet while they were staying there during filming. So as you can see, there is nothing to stop you from going over the edge. So when I had to back up, I had to get on a different angle that put me facing the cliff that I normally would never be. So as you can see in the corner here, they have stones and whatnot to stop you from. People kind of drive a little radically around this, and this is all ice. It's all very slippery. If you're walking, there's a lot of broken bones from people slipping and falling because of this. Now, we'll go on to the babysitting of cars, because this is the most interesting tale that I will be telling today. Just randomly one day, I'll start with, we do have to plug our cars in the north, and the reason we have to plug our cars in is that the batteries will freeze and your radiator will freeze. So you have to keep those warm, otherwise it will freeze and they'll be dead in the morning. And it only takes, one of the things that happened quite frequently at the inn was people who had a beef with management would unplug the vehicle and the next morning it would not start after, a few hours. That's all it took. So you'd have a random neighbor come up to you and say, hey, we're going away for 5 weeks. Can you watch our vehicle? And just like, what? Oh, well, last year when we asked one of the other neighbors, they didn't really drive it, and we ended up having to replace parts in the engine. Now, if you're unfamiliar with how antifreeze works, when you see ones that say works up to 50 below, they mean up to, not including, and beyond. Once you get beyond, it will freeze. And ice does not care about your metal. So the front engine where your radiator is, that will be warmed. Your engine block may be getting warmed a little bit, but there are parts that are not getting warmed and they will eventually freeze, especially when you hit minus 70. And we're not talking about wind chill. We're talking about flat out minus 70. The highest speed limit is about 50, which is what I'm doing here. The rest of the residential areas are only 30 kilometers, and in between is about 40 kilometers. And it's something else to drive. I mean, when the roads are clear like this, it's not bad. But some of the other ones, like just even through the parking lots and whatnot, where it's all solid ice, it is actually rather scary because you can, lose control and go over a cliff, and there's nothing you can do about it. I was very fortunate that nothing happened. And it was 3 years in a row that I ended up having to babysit their car. And I'm glad to say that every time they came back, it was in exactly the same condition. Thank you. Hopefully I can come up with some more interesting material in the future and probably some better footage that isn't so bumpy, because the roads there are terrible for all the reasons you think they might be. Have a good day. Cheers.